अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर जताशिया, पीजीआर एमफिल फिजियोलॉजी इन फिजियोलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डेमोंस्ट्रेट द क्लिनिकल टेस्ट फॉर एग्जामिनेशन ऑफ ऑक्युलोमोटर, ट्रोक्लियर एंड एब्डुसेंट नर्व्स विच आर थर्ड, फोर्थ एंड सिक्स क्रेनियल नर्व्स। थर्ड, फोर्थ एंड सिक्स क्रेनियल नर्व्स आर मोटर नर्व्स एंड कंट्रोल ऑक्युलर मूवमेंट्स। Their nuclei in third and fourth cranial nerves nuclei lie in the midbrain, and for sixth cranial nerve nuclei lie in pons. These cranial nerves bring sensations from proprioceptors in the eye muscles. Objectives to do this practical is to learn names of cranial nerves, their nature, importance of these cranial nerves, effects produced due to lesions of cranial nerves. Principle: examination of cranial nerves is an important part of the clinical assessment. Any cranial nerve can be involved in the disease process in its extra or intracranial course and its site of origin within the brain or brain stem. Protocol: first of all, introduce yourself to the subject or patient. Explain the procedure to him or her. The subject should be calm and comfortable. Perform tests on both sides of the body. These cranial nerves supply extraocular and intraocular muscles. Third cranial nerve, oculomotor nerve, which innervates superior rectus muscle, inferior rectus, medial rectus, inferior oblique muscle. Fourth cranial nerve, trochlear nerve, innervates superior oblique. Sixth cranial nerve, abducens nerve, innervates lateral rectus. Look for ptosis, drooping of upper eyelid, squint, abnormality of ocular movement in which the visual axis do not meet at the point of fixation, nystagmus, involuntary rhythmic to and fro movements of the eyeball. And in the diagram you can see at the top SR3 superior rectus, which is supplied by third cranial nerve, inferior oblique, also third cranial nerve, inferior rectus, also third cranial nerve, and LR6 lateral rectus by abducens, sixth cranial nerve, SO4 superior oblique. ये abbreviation just for your remembrance. कि इनको याद करने का इस तरह से तरीका कार है कि आप इसी तरह से डायग्राम बना के याद कर सकते हैं. In examination, we have to inspect the eyes, size and shape of the pupil in both eyes. If eyes are smaller, we will call this term an ophthalmos. And if size of the eyes are larger and eyes are protuberant, it is called ophthalmos. We have to see symmetry of palpebral fissures, position of the eyelids, observe drooping of eyelids, ptosis, pupillary reflexes, direct and indirect light reflex, refer to the experiment already done. Accommodation reflex: examiner must stabilize the head and chin of the subject. Ask him to follow the examiner's index finger held at a distance of 2 feet. Move finger to the right upward and downward, then left upward and downward, forming letter H. Also check auxiliary movement of eyeball when testing ocular movements, nystagmus. Assalamu alaikum Mr. Amar. Mera naam Dr. Zataishia hai. Mujhe aapki aankhon ka muayna karna hai aur ye muayna aapki bimari ki tashkhees mein muawin sabit hoga. Umeed hai ki mere muayne se aapko koi takleef nahi hogi. Agar koi masla ho to phir aap mujhe bata dein, main apna muayna rok dun. Theek hai ji. Aap ijazat dete hain muayne ke liye?
Ji.
Sanitize your hands with the sanitizer properly. We have to inspect his eyes. Both eyes normal in size and shape. You can see pupils are not dilated. These are centrally located. No abnormality is seen on inspection. Palpebral fissures are symmetrical in both eyes. No drooping of eyelids, so no ptosis. आमिर साहब आपने मेरी उंगली की तरफ देखना है, अपना सर नहीं हिलाना, ठीक है? जिस तरफ मेरी उंगली जाएगी आपने उसी तरफ दोनों आंखों से देखते जाना है। वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द सेंटर, राइट, अपर, डाउनवर्ड, बैक, लेफ्ट साइड, अपर एंड डाउनवर्ड, दैट्स ऑल। आपकी टांग का बहुत बहुत शुक्रिया।